of order with the program. My name is Stuckey Benfield, and I'm here to bring welcoming remarks on behalf of the City of Atlanta. I am Director of Sustainability, and I'm here on behalf of my boss, Mayor Cassine Reed. And since he's not here, hopefully you won't tell him, I'm going to steal a few lines from him. Since I have heard him speak just a few times, he's got a refrain he likes to use when he gives talks. And I'd like to use that line today, and that is, we are at a moment. And when he gives this speech, Mayor Reed then goes on to talk about how the City of Atlanta is at a critical juncture, built on the progress that we've seen during the 2 years that he's been in office. I mean, the two terms. From the fact that the city is on strong fiscal standing with a solid bond rating, growing our cash reserves from $7.4 million when he took office to nearly $142 million, which is where we're expected to end at the end of this year. To the fact that Atlanta has maintained the highest concentration of Fortune 500 companies in the U.S. and recently attracting businesses like Porsche, Worldpay, and NCR. And since we're here at Georgia Tech, the mayor almost always mentions in his remarks how rich our university system is. And I have to say that pains me just a little bit to give a shout out to Georgia Tech since I'm a Delta dog, with 2 degrees from the University of Georgia. But Georgia Tech is undeniably one of the top universities in the country for technology. And it's only fitting that the Solar Summit is here at Georgia Tech, where so much cutting-edge research is going on in renewable energy. So Mayor Reed rightfully talks about how we are at a moment in Atlanta. But I'd like to turn that phrase slightly to say that we are at a moment with solar in Atlanta. With the passage of House Bill 57, and thanks to many people in this room who worked on that effort, especially the Georgia Solar Energy Association and many others here, the bill enabled third-party financing for distributed generation solar. And then the ITC tax credit in place, giving a 30% tax credit for solar installations. And, correct me if I'm wrong, but I think we're blessed with just a little bit of good Georgia sun here in Atlanta. So we've got some terrific synergy right at this moment, at this time, in Atlanta to see solar grow exponentially. And it's no secret that the Reed administration is business friendly. So I want to deliver that message to the solar industry today, that as director of the Mayor's Office of Sustainability, we're here to support solar business in Atlanta. And I wish I could also deliver the message that we have a fully developed solar plan that's ready to deploy solar. And I'm not quite there, but I will say that my office has been vetting a solar plan with the help of Dr. Matt Cox, who's a graduate of this university. And we are thoughtfully exploring options to deploy solar on municipal facilities. And we hope to have that done during the Reed administration while the tax credit is still in place. But the city is going to need the advice and support of Georgia solar industry in order to make that plan a reality. So, in closing, I'll say again, we're at a moment in Atlanta, but no more so than with solar. And I invite you all to support Mayor Reed and our efforts to support solar and make Atlanta one of the top tier. And before we move on to our panel, I am going to do just a brief shameless plug for my office. I'm looking for a new staff person who's got experience in energy efficiency to work on our city energy project and our commercial building energy efficiency ordinance, and also to work on solar projects.